Good morning, friends. I'm Professor Shivayogi Patil, and I'm a trainer and coach, and I'm making this video on behalf of Global College of BSc, BCom, BBA, BCA, MCom, Hubli, which is located in Shelter Layout, or you can call it as Akshay Colony, which is a part of extended part of the Vidyanagar. So, my dear friends, in my previous videos, we have discussed a lot of things which are related to students, how to get success in the students, students in their academic journey, because life itself is a journey and your academy is also a journey. So, every night and every day counts, and every minute and every second counts. And I have told you earlier in my one of the video regarding while discussing the time management, it is not the clock that is ticking. It is your life which is ticking. So you should be very, very careful while wasting that time. Time management is a very important skill for everyone, not only for students, for everyone who wanted to shine in their profession, shine in their family also. So therefore, my dear friends, remember those things. Those are very, very important. So apart from those time management, those goals and other things, so how to shine, how to become a good student? How to become a good student? A good student means what? Just not just trying to be a good human being. Though, of course, that is the basic necessity. So you need to be always a good human being. So what is meant by good human being? A good human being is one, whatever he does it consciously. So that he knows the what you call it as the consequences of his action, and he does things so he also remain happy, as well as his family, his society remains happy. So that is the definition of the good human. So apart from being a good human, how to be a good student, how to shine in academics? Of course, there are many things are required to share in academics. So here we are discussing some of the important traits of how to shine in academics. As I earlier said, you need to have a goal or vision for your academic journey. You should know when you take admission to a college, a degree college or PUC college, where you want to reach exactly, where you want to reach, which company you want to get a job, or things you want to do, whether you want to be an entrepreneur or a consultant or something like that. There are n number of employability opportunities. So you need to have a vision or goal. Then you need to have that time management skills, and your focus should be on short-term goals as well as long-term goals. So your focus should not wander. Your focus should not off the track. Yesterday only I have released a video in which I am emphasizing the fact that today's generation, today's younger generation, especially students, have lost their track of academic because of the pandemic. They are in their comfort zone. They are in their home. So they have lost their focus completely, and they have become complacent. Because becoming complacent and being in comfort zone is very, very easy, and it is self-fulfilling proficiency also. It will give you temporary enjoyment. It will give you definitely a temporary enjoyment. But for long-term gains, you need to come to the track again and start concentrating on your academic journey. So therefore, what I suggest is, to fulfill those goals, to fulfill is the time management. See the days and night, every day as a compartment. Every day as a compartment. For example, so you wake up till when you sleep, that will be one of the compartments. So, of course, we are not considering the period of time for which you go to sleep. We are considering only your wake-up time. So, there also you can make adjustments, you can prioritize, so that every day you will have a pre-planning of reaching your short-term goals. Daily goals are like that. Daily goals are very, very important. Once you have to have daily goals, you have to have weekly goals, you have to have monthly goals, then you have to have semester goals, you have to have yearly goals, and finally, you can have a complete academic goal. So that is very, very essential if you want to be a very good student. Very good student, because student is the definition of students is itself seeker of knowledge. Seeker of knowledge. Knowledge may be anything like in which college you have taken admission. So to which branch you have taken admission. So that, of course, that is not life. There is a lot to be, knowledge is something more than that. But at least for you as a student, that is the knowledge you need to acquire. So the first thing what I suggest is, start loving your academic career. Start loving your subjects. So because as I told you earlier also, see, choosing an academic career is like choosing your life partner. So you choose your life partner based either, or you have there are two types of marriages. One is the love marriage, another is the arranged marriage. In love marriage, first you choose your life partner, you like someone and you develop some affection and love towards him, and then you marry him, okay, with the consent of your family or without the consent of your family, something like that. So love marriages happens. But it is also important to keep that love after marriage also. Otherwise, what happens? Most of the love marriages are broken, led to divorces, because so since they feel secure that they are already married, so they stopped the loving each other, something like that. Then there will be a number of things, like there will be ego clashes, there will be career decisions, there will be other clashes, household clashes, financial clashes and all, and finally which led to the breakup, or what we call it as a divorce. Then the second thing is what you call it as the arranged marriage. In arranged marriage, advantage, okay, the disadvantage is you don't know how your life partner is, how he is going to be. So that become an advantage also, that become a disadvantage. Because once you get married to that person, so you have to start loving him. You have to start loving him or her. Then only your marriage sustains. Otherwise, okay, Indian tradition has this thing called tolerances and all those things. Indian culture doesn't allow these breakups and divorces, especially in case of arranged marriages, so easily arranged marriages. So that doesn't allow. That is a different matter altogether. But if your marriage has to be successful, if the marriage need to give the required happiness, so throughout your life, then you start loving that unknown person whom you have married. So one advantage with arranged marriage is, earlier you don't know anything about that man, and once, so that you can easily cope up with his kind of ego, his kind of things. But in love marriage, it doesn't happen. Love marriage, what happens? The boy or the girl simply hide their weaknesses and project only their strengths, or sometimes they act also. So that leads to difficulty when they get married, when they were on their own. So they start understanding the weaknesses of each other, and things started getting out of hand. But in case of arranged marriage, so the advantage is, since you don't know exactly the nature of the person you are marrying, whether he or her, so it will be easier for you to adapt to whatever the type of person he is, his temperament, his ego, his this thing and all. Of course, you need to develop mutual respect for each other, and you need to develop that healthy relation to marriage to sustain. So why I'm telling you all these things is, Your academic career is also like a marriage. So once you, taken admission to a college and chosen a career option like BCom or BBA or BCA or MCom or something like that, you have married to that branch, you have married to that college. So you have to start liking that, you have to start loving that. So there will be discrepancies in everything. No, nothing is perfect in this world. So there might be some things which might not be going according to your expectations, your earlier expectations, like what happens in the marriages. So this, so you have to ignore all those things. You have to come out of that complaining mode, come out of that blaming mode, and you have to start expecting things as it is, and you have to try to extract as much as possible in with the resources available to you, with the resources that are there in the college, that are there in the things. So you have to start loving it. So once you start love it, because there is a for actually this saying is for job holder. If you love your job, you don't need to work. If you love your profession, you don't need to work. You will never get tired, something like that. So similarly here also, if you love your academic career, if you love your branch, if you love your college, so then you will not get exhausted. You will not get exhausted. Because, okay, the fatigue what you experience as a student is most of the times it will be mental. It is not physical actually, right? Because it has been scientifically proved. It is a mental fatigue. Fatigue means what? Doing the repetitive things, you get bored. So that is called fatigue. Students normally experience the fatigue, experience the stress. So if you love that, whatever you are doing, if you love the process of studying, process of absorbing the knowledge from books, from classroom, from practicals, from workshops, from trainings. So if you love that knowledge itself, and once you start loving that knowledge, what you wanted to get, then you start loving the things what are happening in your academic career, whether it is a training or a workshop or classroom teaching or books and all. So you should start loving it, because that knowledge is going to serve throughout the life. Of course, learning is a lifelong process, but at least it will build up your career, and you can enjoy throughout your life. Whatever enjoyment plans you have, you have to curb for at least 3 to 4 years or 4 to 5 years during your academic journey, and you can enjoy the whole life is left for you to enjoy the life. So to fulfill any of your dream in future, you need to start loving your knowledge. Loving your knowledge you are going to acquire. Loving your knowledge you are going to acquire means you have to start loving the subjects. So whatever may be subject, it may be mathematics, it may be statistics, it may be accountancy, it may be financial analysis. So whatever may be subject, and however your feelings might be, because you feel that some subjects are very dry subjects, some subjects are good, some subject. Because why you feel like that? There are many reasons. Okay, there are many reasons. But one thing what I observed is, our students actually want to get entertained also. Information is different, entertainment is different. So don't expect that kind of entertainment, that kind of things from every professor, every teacher. So every teacher is not capable of that. Otherwise, so every teacher would have become popular. Only few teachers have that, capability to blend humor, blend jokes, make the class entertaining. Don't expect that, because you are not here to get entertained. You are here to get the information. You are here to get the knowledge. You are here to get seek the knowledge. So however serious may be your faculty, however dry a subject you may feel, because sometimes the theoretical subject, the long paragraphs may feel frustrated to some people, some students. Some students learn, so sorry, some students love theory, but the analytical parts, mathematical parts and all, they become tough nut to crack for. So you should change the mindset. It is all in the mind. You should change the mindset and you should be able to adjust yourself. Flexibility is very, very important. So once you start loving your subject and generate interest in that subject, and you have to see your entire life vision in books, entire life vision in your college, entire life vision in your classrooms, and entire life vision in trainings, whatever you get in the college. So you have your own vision, you have your own dreams, you have your own dream of comfortable life or luxurious life. You should see that, you should visualize that. It is in your book. So only by completing this book, understanding the knowledge in this book, I can achieve my dreams. This should come into your mind. Then only you start loving your subject. Once you start loving, or you can use the word liking, better word, liking your subjects, then that boredom doesn't happen. Neither in reading, nor in attending the classroom, but in the trainings. So therefore, my dear friends, don't expect entertainment in the college. So college is, of course, joyful moments are there, and every college try to provide as much as enjoyment also for their students so that they can enjoy their academic journey. But your expectation should not be like it is not like a Ravi Chandran movie or any other what do you call the college campus movies that are getting released nowadays. So college is a serious stuff. Getting knowledge is also a serious step, which is very, very essential to reach the destination what you want to reach. So therefore, start liking your college, start liking your what you call branch, start liking your, because I have seen many students, they will take admission to a particular branch. Then somehow, I don't know, maybe some subject, maybe they may feel tough. See, tough, it is again a mental, what you call, barrier. Because what we are reading, what knowledge we are acquiring, we are not acquiring any new knowledge. It is already there in books. Who has written those books? Some people or some scientists, some people who were earlier like us, they have acquired that knowledge, then they applied it practically, they have conducted experiment, and based on their active experiment, that knowledge has been put into book. So already they have invented whatever they have invented. You are not inventing anything. You have not created yet anything. So tomorrow you may create, tomorrow you may invent based on your knowledge. But right now, you are reading something which is written by some already. So he is also a human being and you are also a human being. He is not an extraordinary person. So he was also an ordinary person like you. And he's a student. Life might be similar like you, with his mentality might be similar like you during his study period. But somehow he liked the subject, a particular subject, gained much knowledge, experimented on it, applied it practically, and with all the results, he has written a book, something like that. So if you understand these intricacies of your subject, see the subject and understand that I'm not reading something out of this world or something very, very new. How can I understand this? See, there is a saying, if one can do, everybody can do. If one can do, everybody can do, or anybody can do. So that is one of the presuppositions in neuro-linguistic programming. If one can do, definitely you can do. So if he can acquire so much of knowledge so that he can write a book, see, you are just reading his book and gaining the knowledge he has already mastered. So your effort should be again mastering it so that you can create something more. You can create something more, or you can invent something different than him by applying it practically. So if you think in these lines, if you start thinking the intricacies of the knowledge, intricacies of the subject, intricacies of the acquiring knowledge. So acquiring knowledge is nothing but, of course, considering today's examination system, it is just memorizing the things. So memorizing the things and organizing the things very effectively in your mind, systematically in your mind, so that you can recall it at the time you want, or at any given moment, at the time of your desire, have to acquire it. You have to recall it. So recalling is very, very important. Without recalling capacity, your memory is nothing. So therefore, my dear friends, so remember that. So it is quite essential to start liking every subject. Start liking every subject. And if you are finding difficulty, there are faculties to help you. And there are old books that can correct your fundamentals, as I said in my earlier videos. So correct your fundamentals. Once you correct your fundamentals, or once you update your fundamentals during the previous years of your study, definitely you will start understanding things. Once you start understanding things, you start liking it. So once you start liking it, so you start enjoying it. Because I have seen many students, usually the students, rank students, they enjoy their study. They sit at night, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, and all those things. They do experience. See, I think you know or don't know, the premier institute like NIIT, IITs, and all, they run 24/7. Anytime the student can enter the library and read it. So he might take rest in the whenever you want, and he may wake up at night 10 o'clock because since after college he may want to take some rest. So 10 o'clock he may enter the library and start reading till 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, something like that also. So I have seen it, and the labs. So because labs, our practicals are the practical implementation of knowledge what you have acquired in the theory classes. So labs gives you much more clarity. Practicals are designed to give you much more clarity about the bookish knowledges. So therefore, labs are very, very important. So I have told you, in premier institutes, the college run 24/7, so that any student can enter at any time, even night at 2 o'clock. So there will be a person who is in charge of the lab, and he will allow you to conduct the experiments. So by doing that, they will acquire something called as research sponsors. So then all those, after completion of academic career, they go for researches, they acquire doctorates and all other laurels they will get. So therefore, my dear friends, with this small video, I am telling you that start liking your subject, start liking your branch, start liking your college, despite all of the things which doesn't meet your expectations. See, there is nothing right and wrong. There is nothing perfect in this world. No college is perfect. No branch is perfect. No professor or trainer is perfect. So everybody has their own style of teaching. Everybody has their own method of teaching. Some may have that art of entertaining along with giving the knowledge. Some may not have it. Some may be look very serious. So I have seen many NPTEL videos of premier institute professor. They were very serious because their job is to give the knowledge, not to entertain you. So don't consider the college as an entertainment center. Be serious, because I will give you an example. See, I used to tell to this my engineering students to whom I used to teach, in the medical colleges, why they run so professionally and why students are more knowledgeable there means, normally, at least 50 to 60% of students in medical colleges are very serious about their career. It is because once they take admission to the medical college, this is very, very important to understand. Once you take the admission to the medical college, they change their mental setup. They think that they are doctors. And to add value to that thought, they will be given an apron, they will be given a stethoscope from the first year itself. So that idea add that value to their thinking of they are already doctors. So they start behaving professionally. They start behaving professionally. They become serious about their career, about their studies. So of course, since he has taken admission to medical college, he is good in academia. He had a better score in examination. So he might be a good learner. So that is different thing. But even if that, so once you take admission to any of the colleges, you need to become that part of it. So for example, you take admission to BCom. So you are a BCom, you are a commerce student. You are a commerce student. Commerce student is no, not in anything inferior to a doctor or an engineer. So the commerce is the backbone of Indian economy. So therefore, you should start feeling that professionalism. So therefore, I urge, see, I discard this categorization of professional colleges and non-professional colleges. Everything is professional. Even arts, art is a professional. Arts colleges. See, psychology students, there is a subject called psychology, branch called psychology in arts. There is a branch called criminology in arts. They are very good professions, highly paid professions. So when you take admission to either BCom or, for example, BBA, you start behaving professionally like a manager or an administrator because you are taken admission to an administrative college. So similarly in BCom, you start behaving like a chartered accountant. So that behavior, that professional behavior should come to you. Then only your mind will be totally concentrated or focused on building your career. Building your career and you know, on your branch, on your subjects. Otherwise, what happens is there are hundreds of distractions in your world. You are just your, of course, there will be something called bad company and all those things we'll discuss in other videos. So you start, you feel like you are enjoying life. College life is for enjoying and all those things. College life is golden life. College life is golden life is a line. Or slogan created to emphasize the fact that it will lay foundation to your bright career. So it is not that called a college life is golden life and implicate you have to enjoy your college life, something like that. So no. So at least for college, in the college, when you are a college campus, you need to focus on the academics and you look professional. So you should look professional by your clothes also, by look, you look professional by your looks also. So I think you understand what I mean. So today's students, how they come to college with that what you call TLD jeans and those t-shirts. We can't make up whether he dresses the same dresses in your his room or house or So most of the student doesn't come in for formal dresses. That trend has been, and college authorities are complacent about that. They may lose students, something like that. So of course, the colleges who have uniform, that is the better. That is the better this thing to have uniform, so that there will be uniformity. So my dear friends, this video is going very long, so a lot of things to say. So start this video is just start liking your profession, start liking your career, start liking your college, start liking your branch, start liking your subjects. Unless you like it, you feel tired, you will feel stressful, you feel fatigued. And within no time, you that complacency creeps in, that laziness creeps in, that lethargy creeps in, and everything go haywire. Therefore, my dear friends, please follow, please understand the crux of this video. So if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Many more videos are coming and I'm going to discuss many other topics. So thank you for your active listening. Thank you.